Yeah. Come on, y'all. We're gonna take everything that the devil stole.
Your mind is made up that you're taking back tonight everything that the devil has stolen from you. I hope you're so mad tonight that you're going to go into the devil's camp and take back everything that he stole from you. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Now, I don't need you to sit on the praise and the worship tonight. I don't need you to sit on what God wants to do tonight. I need everybody that loves Jesus to proclaim the name of the Lord and to give him some shows of praise and get yourself ready to hear the word of the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus.
Somebody lift your voice in this place.
Can be planted and received through God's seed system. He said it in Genesis. He said, as long as the earth remains, there will always be seed time and harvest. That means I can sow my way into anything that I want. If I want some love, I don't have to convince nobody to like me. If I want some love, I don't have to talk nobody into wanting me. Hallelujah. But I gotta sow some seeds of love. Hallelujah. Gotta have a smile on my face. Gotta forgive some folk. And everything that I release in seed form has to come back to me in a harvest. So whatever I don't have is not a problem of harvest. It's a problem of seed. Ask your neighbor, have you sown what you want lately? Have you sown what you want? Have you sown? I'm telling you, I know what I know. Hallelujah. You want some kindness? You show some kindness. Hallelujah. And don't get stuck by the weeds that have been trying to grow up on your row. Hallelujah. Because God got the Holy Ghost there to take care of the wheat and the tear. Y'all still with me? All you do is sow your seed. Hallelujah. If you want love, you sow some love. If you want some joy, you sow some joy. Hallelujah. And you know what? If you want more tears, just keep crying. You want some sadness? Just keep releasing it. He said to you that the joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. So you are going to have to sow some seed and rejoice in God so that you can get your harvest. I never forget. Bishop and I were so backed up, we didn't know what else to do with ourselves. Hallelujah. Y'all know how the economy is, but we decided to get out of the system. Hallelujah. We just decided we're not going to depend on the world system. We're going to do God's way. And you know, God has given us some land, and it was, look, agriculture.
To pieces. Improper relationships has caused it to be without hope. Sin has destroyed it. Despair surrounds it. Unhappiness overwhelms it. Might look like the end is near. Might look like it's time for you to give up. But I came tonight to tell you that it ain't over. Because you know what, my sisters and brothers, it doesn't matter what it looks like. Look at somebody and say, it doesn't matter what it looks like. It ain't over. In other words, your turnaround comes when you begin to hear from God. See, you hear from God, but what you do with what you hear makes the difference in where you end up. We hear the word, but we don't do the word. We hear the word, but we don't practice the word. We hear the word, but we don't live in the word. So we need to just stop hearing the word. The Bible says faith without works is what? Yeah. Right, just like in the cemetery, dead. The question is, who is speaking to you? Who is speaking to you? Who are you listening to? And then another question, which report do you believe? See, you gotta know that you know that you know that you're hearing from God. And if you're going to be fruitful, you know, you gotta understand that words have power, y'all. You gotta speak the word. You gotta prophesy the word. You gotta declare the word. God gave Ezekiel a command in verse number 4 to prophesy. prophesying is not speaking to a person or a thing regarding where it is now, but boldly proclaiming where it is going to be later. See, prophecy never deals with the past or the present. It only deals with the future. And when you are in a mess, don't settle for a word of knowledge. It only reveals the things that you've been through or what you're going through. Can't even laugh no more because stuff has weighed you down. But the word of the Lord says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Hallelujah. And when I feel like I can't go another further, I just think about, I get the joy of the Lord. I'm not talking about happy. I'm talking about the joy of the Lord. So I told you before, stuff gonna make you happy. A new car gonna make you happy, hon, don't. Hallelujah. Some money gonna make you happy, Elder G. Hallelujah. Your children doing right gonna make you happy every now and then. But do you have joy when they act a plump fool? Can you still have joy if they wreck your car? Can you still have joy when all your money is gone? You can shake my pockets all you want. You ain't gonna hear a thing up in there. But I still have joy. Hallelujah. When chaos is all around you, can you still have the peace of God? Hallelujah. Some of you let stuff take your peace. Always in confusion. If there's confusion going on, your name gonna come up. It's because the devil likes mess. And he got some hand-picked folk that he know he could bring to his party. Hallelujah. But if you want the peace of God, he's ready to restore. Hallelujah. He's ready to give. I know you had it before. Restore means getting it back. So he's ready to give it back to you. Amen. Relationships that have been broken. Amen. Husband and wives, mothers and daughters, fathers and sons. God can mend relationships today. Hallelujah. You think you can't talk to your mom. You think you can't talk to your dad because of stuff that happened 20 years ago. God can mend that thing. Hallelujah. He can do it all over again. So if you had it, you lost it, you can get it back. Because God is a restorer. Hallelujah. He said he'll give it all back to you.
Things that the devil stole.